In today's video, we're doing UV photography of dandelions. It's a really interesting effect, a really interesting subject. So stick around and I'll show you exactly how it's done. Hi guys, I'm Ben from AdaptiLux and welcome back to another macro photography tutorial where today we're shooting dandelions again. It is the season for dandelions and there's so much that can be done with them. I thought we'd do something a little bit different to the video that we did a couple of weeks ago. If you want to see some shots, super close-up macro of these individual seeds, hit the link in the top right-hand corner from when we took a look at these things up close using a reversed lens setup. Today we're doing something a little bit different. We're going to be using a really specialist effect, and that is UV photography. To be more precise, UV-induced visible fluorescence photography. That's a type of UV photography that doesn't require any modifications to your camera. So it's a really easy type of photography to get into. It just sounds a little bit technical, and it creates some really cool effects. There is one thing that you need for UV IVF photography, and that is a UV light source. The UV light sources that I'm using today are our own UV lighting arms. Now, these are a specialist type of lighting arm that produces pure UV light. So when we plug them into a control pod, you'll notice that they don't turn on, or it seems like they don't turn on. This one is actually on, but simply because it's got this blocking filter in the end here. This is a band pass filter. It will only allow pure UV light out of the end of the arm. And that's exactly what we need for UV IVF photography. For the sake of keeping this video nice and short and succinct, if you want some more information about the science behind why UV light is going to induce some fluorescence in our subjects, I will link to another video up in the top right-hand corner where you can go and get the brief introduction into UV photography. For now, all you need to know is that you need a pure UV light source, you need a camera and a subject, and you need a completely dark environment. So you might be thinking, your environment doesn't look very dark, and it's not. But it's really hard to work in the dark with photography. You'll need to focus still, you'll need to see what you're doing to compose your image. So I'm going to do all of that in the light, and then when I'm ready to take my photograph, I'll turn out all of these lights and try and make my room as dark as possible. So first things first, let's compose and focus on our subject. So just as you normally would, set up your camera and your subject. I've got my dandelion sat in a macro subject holder here, holding it nice and steady in front of my lens. I'm using a 100mm f2.8 Tokina lens, so I've got a lot of movement that I can come close and get nice and close in here, but I can also move back and get the whole thing in focus. I'm looking at my dandelion here through a tiny little hole. I've actually plucked out some of the seeds off the front of the dandelion so that I can get a little window into the interior. Not only is that going to help see all of the detail on the very center of the flower, but also it's going to give us a better view into the back range of seedlings coming out. The fur, the little fluffy bits from the surrounding area do a pretty good job of obscuring any detail on the inside if you just try and look through them. So I think plucking a little bit out of the front is an interesting way to get a shot of a dandelion. That's up to you. I see a lot of people getting really successful shots without taking any out of the front. But for me, I'm going to try and get a nice shot showing the detail of the inside of the dandelion. I also have a sneaking suspicion that when we get some UV light onto this thing, that center little bulb is actually going to glow quite nicely. So I'm looking forward to seeing that. Next, we're going to need some lighting. So as I've already mentioned, the source of our UV light is going to be from the AdaptiLux Studio. So I'm going to be attaching my control pod here to a little mini tripod. That's going to give us a nice amount of elevation to be able to get UV lighting arms all the way around our subject. So I need to plug in a few of those UV lighting arms just to get an idea of how much my subject glows. So a question we get asked quite often is how many UV lighting arms do you actually need to achieve UV photography? Well, if we're just talking about trying it out, you can absolutely get this effect using only one UV lighting arm. More UV lighting arms are only going to improve your settings by putting more UV down onto your subject and therefore making it glow a little bit more, but they're also going to reduce shadows. UV light works in exactly the same way as normal light, so if part of your subject is blocked from the UV light, it's not going to glow. That means for a spherical subject like ours, we do need a little bit of light coming from multiple directions. As I've got my light set up here, all coming from one side, only this side of the dandelion is going to glow. There's no UV light coming from the other side, so nothing on this side will glow. So I'm going to move my setup around and try and find a nice balance between different UV lighting arms coming from different directions. Obviously, the more UV lighting arms you have, the more options you have of directions of light to come from. I'd say at the very least, for a balanced setup, you should go for two UV lighting arms so that you can bring light from both directions. So check out the final setup of UV lighting arms. I've got three UV lighting arms, one coming in from the top, one is coming down from the top and slightly forward, and one is coming up from the bottom. Now, obviously you can't see that these are actually doing anything because the lights are still on, but I can assure you that when we turn the lights off, all of this is going to glow, and hopefully it will glow nice and evenly across the top circumference of our dandelion. Now, I do have another UV lighting arm on standby if I need to fill in any blanks here, if there's parts of this dandelion that I think should be glowing and are not, I can bring in that extra lighting arm just to fill that gap. Now, I am going to be focus stacking here, but first I'm just going to take a quick test shot to see what this looks like. What I saw there was that my room is not nearly dark enough. I can see things in the background, and that also means that some visible light is probably falling on my subject as well as the UV. What that's going to do is lower the contrast of our interesting effect. We want our glowing pieces to stand out as much as possible, and anything that isn't glowing should be faded off into the background and not as prominent as our big glowing centerpiece, which does glow, by the way, as I expected it would. So what I'm going to do is block up the window that was letting in just a little bit of light, turn off the TV, which was leaving tiny little bits of LEDs coming in from the standby, and it can just be little light leaks like that that make all of the difference. For my next shots though, I'm going to go straight into focus stacking. The way that I'm going to do this is not by turning the lights on and refocusing every single time. I'm going to set my focus at its deepest level and then slowly make my way back, just judging how far I'm moving it each time. When I've moved it far enough, I should have a full stack of UV images. Now, this is going to take a little while because each of these is actually a long exposure. I'm going to try and get my shutter speed down as much as possible. I don't want to be doing dozens of 20-second exposures. I'm going to aim for about 5-second exposures here, and that might mean sacrificing a little bit of aperture or perhaps my ISO. I'm pretty happy with that stack. I think that this thing looks really interesting under UV. So I'm going to repeat that entire process, getting a little bit closer and seeing if I can't capture a little bit of that interior detail and the detail on some of the seeds. Something I neglected to mention the last time around is that I am using a shutter release cable. It's really easy to bump your camera or just shift your focus a little bit whilst you're meddling around in the dark. So I do recommend taking a step back and using some sort of remote triggering just to make sure that you don't disturb your shots between stack shots. So I'm going to repeat my process and see if I can't get a little bit closer. So getting a little bit closer into our dandelion center shows off that glowing orb that is in the middle of our dandelion. And you need to remember that the only light that is in this image is that which is created by the dandelion itself. So that glowing orb in the middle, the center of the flower, is actually lighting all of the seeds around it that aren't glowing quite as much. I find that absolutely fascinating, and I think this is a really interesting way to shoot a pretty common subject. We see photos of dandelions quite often, but we don't often see how they glow under UV. I think the dandelions are another thing to add to our growing list of cool things to shoot under UV. If you want to see some more examples of UV subjects, I suggest subscribing to the YouTube channel and taking a look at some of the links in the description and in the top right-hand corner. I'll link to some really interesting shots of kiwis under UV and some lichen. Now, I think I've had enough of playing around with dandelions in the dark. My dandelion is looking a little bit worse for wear as I've messed around with it and plucked it a little bit too much. So I'm going to call it a day. But I'd like to know from you guys what you think to today's shoot and what you think to UV photography of dandelions. Let me know down in the comments and make sure to hit the like button on the video if you enjoyed it. For now, that is all that I've got time for. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.